Today I thought I would show you how to do the interlocking shells pattern. It's a really pretty, nice sort of dense fabric for a blanket. The reason I've picked this one today is this is quite an old make of mine. It's actually a huge blanket. I can't get it all in shots. Absolutely massive. But over Christmas, I started making one using slightly larger yarn. And as you can see, I ran out of yarn. So quite early into the blanket, I've run out of yarn. So I thought this is actually, whilst I'm waiting for a delivery, this is the perfect opportunity to show you guys how you can make your very own sort of interlocking shell blanket. This isn't my pattern. I didn't invent this stitch. It's just a stitch. So I can't really claim credit for it, but I can show you how to make it. So this one is made with a 4mm hook and some really gorgeous rooster almerino yarn. This is the Caron version. I don't have any double knit balls to show you because they're all in this. It's quite pricey yarn. This whole blanket cost me the best part of £120. Ouch. So as a result, I don't really use it very much. It's just kind of folded up neatly on the side. I'm a bit frightened about, I don't know, I'm frightened to use it. So that was using this yarn, so it's really squishy. But this larger version over here, which I'm going to show you today, is made, or is being made, I should say, with Caron Simply Soft. So it grows an awful lot quicker than this double knit version. But I just wanted to show you this one so you can see what it looks like in colour. So you're not just stuck thinking this is sort of, you know, muted greys and whites are the only way you can go. So that's enough waffle from me. I'll get on to show you how to make the pattern. So we're going to make a small little swatch of the interlocking shells so you can see how it's built up. It's a two row repeat. I'm going to be using Caron Simply Soft and a 6mm crochet hook. So the pattern is a multiple of 6 plus 3. So what that means is you keep chaining 6, 6, 6, 6, 6 for as wide as you want your blanket to be. And then when you've got it to the desired width, you then add 3 chains. So for this tiny little sample, we're going to chain 24. That's chain number 24. So now you've got it to the desired width, chain 3. So now you've got the right amount of chains, you are going to be working into your third chain from your hook. Remember, the loop on your hook doesn't count as anything. You're counting these chains here. So 1, 2, 3. So working into the third chain, you're going to put 2 double crochets. That's 1. That's 2. Now you're going to skip 2 chains, 1, 2, and then pop a single crochet in here. Skip 2 chains and put 5 double crochets all into the same chain space, or chain, sorry. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Skip 2 chains, single crochet into the next. So if you were making a larger blanket and you had a really long chain, you do 5 double crochets, skip 2 chains, single crochet, skip 2 chains, 5 double crochet, skip 2 chains, single crochet, all the way along. So we've only got a couple to do here. So skip, 5 double crochet. So many yarn problems today. Let me just sort this out. Talk amongst yourselves. Ah, okay. Skip 2 chains, single crochet. Skip 2 chains. 5 double crochet. So when you reach the end, you'll have a whole long row, or if you're just doing this sample with me, you'll have 3 shells consisting of 5 double crochet with single crochets in between. So you're going to end in this very last chain here with 3 double crochet. Like so. So if you are following along with this color scheme, this is just this first little setup row. So if you want to have 2 rows of color like these, which really sort of give that nice shell, you would change color now, ready to start this row. So because I'm going to change color here, you don't have to, of course, you could just do the whole blanket in one color. But because I'm changing color, what I would do is just step back this final double crochet, 1 little tiny bit, so you've got the 2 loops remaining. Like so. And then you bring in your new color. I'm gonna grab white because it was the closest one I had to hand. Hopefully this one won't be as tangled as gray. And then you finish off the end section of your stitch with the new color. So instead of yarning over, pulling through with the gray, you just yarn over, pull through with your next color, like so. And you want to snip the gray, giving yourself a nice long end for weaving in later. And that is your little tiny setup row done. So from now, the next 2 rows are the pattern repeat. So you're going to chain 1 and turn your work. Pop a single crochet into the top of that last double crochet you just did. So your very first stitch. Ignore that one's being a little loose because of course change color. Now you're going to chain 2 and then we're going to do a double crochet, 5 together over the next 5 stitches. So if you're not sure how to double crochet together, I do have a video which only shows you how to double crochet 2 together, but the premise is the same, but I will talk you through how you do a double crochet 5 together. So yarn over, go into the top of the first stitch, come back 3, you've got 3 loops. Yarn over, pull through 2, and then stop. Yarn over, go into the next stitch. Yarn over, come through. Yarn over, pull through 2, stop. Now you're going to go into the third one here. So yarn over, into the stitch, back through, yarn over, pull through 2, stop. As you can see, we've got double crochets, all half finished, hanging off underneath the hook. Again, yarn over into the next stitch, come back through, yarn over, pull through two, stop. One, two, three, four of them. Now you're going to do the fifth one over here, into the next stitch, yarn over, into the very next stitch, back through, yarn over, pull through two, stop. So you can see you've got one, two, three, four, five double crochets, all unfinished, hanging off your hook. So the way you bring them together is yarn over and pull through all the loops on your hook. Like so. That's double crochet five together. Now you're going to chain two, single crochet into the next stitch. Chain two, double crochet five together over the next five stitches. Now don't forget, you're going into the double crochets in row below and the single crochet. So it's over one, two, three, four, five stitches. So double crochet five together. Chain two, single crochet into the next stitch, chain two, double crochet five together. Those chains right from the very beginning over here. Sometimes they're a little bit tricky to see, but right in your turning chain, the chains you skipped right in the beginning. I'm going to pop a single crochet in there. Turn your work, keeping with the white. Chain three. This counts as a double crochet stitch. And then you're going to pop two more double crochets into the top of your single crochet from the row below. It's one, two. You're going to pop a single crochet into the top of your double crochet fives together. So you'll see there's like a little, in my finger might help show you, a little hole in there. It's going to pop a single crochet right in there. So under those two loops. And then into your single crochet, you're going to put five double crochets. So right into the top of that stitch, just five double crochets. Single crochet into the top of your double crochet five together. So there it is again, that little hole. So you're putting it into the top of your stitches, not into these chain two spaces, into the actual stitch. And into the single crochet, five double crochets. Single crochet to the top of your double crochet five together, five double crochet into your single crochet. in this pattern, when it's worked over a larger area, actually you get really used to it. It builds really nice and quickly. It's quite intuitive once you've got the first couple of rows done. You're not constantly thinking what's next, because it's these rows, those rows, nice and simple. Single crochet into that. And then you're going to end the row with three double crochets into your single crochet here. You're also, if you want to, going to change colour, because we've done two rows. So again, if you're changing colour, or you change on your last stitch, so because we're popping three in here, so it's one, two, and then my third, I'm going to yarn over, pull through two, and then when I've still got two loops, bring this grey back in, just fall under the floor, bring the grey back in, yarn over and pull through the last two stitches, and then you can snip your white. So that's it. It's actually a really nice, easy, just a two row repeat. Nice and simple. It builds up really nicely, especially if you change colours every two rows. I hope that was nice and easy for you to understand. If you've got any questions, feel free to comment below. The colours I've used in this blanket are down here, and the materials I've used. If you have any questions, feel free to shout. If you wanted to go ahead and subscribe, that would be amazing. And that's pretty much it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoy the interlocking shell stitch. It's beautiful, I can't recommend it enough. And as I said earlier, once you get into the swing of it, it's a really nice, simple two-row pattern repeat. It's mindless, you can do it in front of the telly. It's great. So happy crocheting, and I shall see you all again soon.